Thank you. Things where you have to be, you're playing something that's very internal, but you actually have to externalize the internal, right? So you can't go, okay, I'm gonna make it open and look at, no, but it's actually a very, private moment.
Well, I actually focus on my sound, the change of the sound so they could feel it together with me. But I should really ask this question to you.
You see, I don't have the answer, and the reason I do these things is so that I can get some answers. It's very important, But, I do have a suggestion, but it's nothing for you to do, actually. It's for Mr. No Brain Pianist. I'd love for you to actually see if in the third movement, which is... just play the beginning phrase without cello. So let's just listen. Let's actually see whether he can motivate you. Okay? So that means, you're not 10 fingers, you are many people. And so give the kind of, beautiful but intimate body of sound of many strings, okay? And see, just play this alone. It's like, you know, it's so funny because he orchestrates it so, where sometimes it's just, it's like a pearl, you know where you need to put something, right? And it's just, you're alone, and it's just, it's there for you to pluck. It's like low-hanging fruit, you know, you just go, and it's beautiful. And you, Mr. Now, brain-filled, it's in sometimes when you play concerto, or when you do a lot of things, you feel like you have to do it alone. You don't have to do it alone. You know, that's the big secret of playing with people. They're there to help. And so just try it again, and just, you know, don't even try too hard. Just listen to him. Make him important. Wipe that smirk off your telling the story or an old person telling the story. You can decide that. You know, you don't have to say, oh, well, you know, I'm this age, therefore I'm a young person. But you can decide, it's your choice. You know, the notes are written there, but how you want to tell that story, from what point of view, and therefore this is your perspective. So it's not the notes, it's your view of the notes that's going to be speaking to all of us when you especially play the last movement, right? So you tell me, how old is this narrator?
Does it have to be the same person telling the story from the beginning to the end?
Good question. Tell me what you're thinking.
I see. So, in the beginning, I think I want to be not old, maybe 40-ish. And when it gets to the very end, when we come back to the third movement materials, I want
middle-aged to very old, right? Okay. And what are some of the experiences the 40-year-old goes through?
I wouldn't know.
Well, the story. So what would you want to look? Did you ever play princess as a kid? Maybe a yeah, little girl, right? So, you know, right? So basically, same idea.
40 years. I'm thinking about it. Maybe some of the adventures that you have gone through in different, with different cultures and different kinds of success and failures.
See, I think when you tell a story, the more specific that you can be, the better. So, for example, you know, so let's go to the, you know, to the coda where you are. So, have you ever, this is like a question for all of you. Have you ever experienced something that is an event, piece of news or an actual happening to you that is so big, so mind-blowing that it changes everything? You feel like the bottom dropped out of your universe. You know, have you suddenly felt like, you know, whatever was stable, like the stage, for example, if there were, you know, an earthquake and suddenly, you know, the stage is no more, you know, that kind of thing. Have you ever experienced anything like that, or thought about it, or, you know?
Yeah. I think so. When?
No. Can you describe?
Yeah, you felt like I had no ground to stand. Like an absolute desert, something. No directions, no, nothing basically, yeah.
So why don't you start with a coda and play blah, 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 you know, and really play those as like real sort of, you know, destiny, fate kind of, you know, hits, right? And don't. Experience, it could be a film, it could be a novel, it could be something, a friend, it, you know, I'm not saying, okay, you know, but it's got to match the thing that you think it was, okay? So which means that you have to determine what your relationship is to the orchestra. You have to determine, are you going together? Are you like, you know, are you going through the tsunami together and it's like, or are you completely wrenched apart and you're struggling or whatever. You have to create that relationship at that moment, and it has to be, you have to somehow mutually agree, boom, that this is the new world order post event, right? So try it again, or you can talk to one another in secret.
Thank you.
the molto elegante too. Absolutely desperate. What happens? The ground goes away. Your sense of time is completely skewed because you're flailing about. You have nothing, you know. And right now it's sort of like you're in slight contemplation mode. So what I want to do is for you, not necessarily now, but to try and think about this and to bridge the distance between what you say something might be and how it's coming out, right? You locate something and you go towards it, and until you reach it, until it's like, right? And it's gotta be, you know, and it's something that is so totally out of the ordinary, you know, whether, so, and it's like, and so that's something you gotta imagine. All right. So let's try a couple of characters. What are some characters that you try and you want to bring out in the last movement?
The one I just tried, the desperate part.
Yeah.
And heroic moments.
Okay. I mean, how about da 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 da? What is that character? Happy and cute, okay. And is it happy and cute at 9 o'clock in the morning?
I shouldn't say happy, I guess. It's more like ignorant happiness.
Ignorant happy, like foolish happiness?
No, it's more like also personal. Like less emotional.
Hmm?
Less emotional.
Less emotional. Okay, show me what you mean, because I think I'm beginning to zero in on something. Much more specificity, right? You know, so if I ask you a question, you actually have to tell me, like, you know, it's this thing that I'm imagining. do you know what I mean? Using your what?
My what?
Tough one. But for example, I think this da 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 da. It's like someone who's actually kind of almost, you know, wildly swaying and, you know, and not steady on his or her feet, you know. But because you have those things, da 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 da. You know, it's like you have these surges, lunges at odd moments, right? You've got to explain that somehow physically. Who would do that? You know, could it be a homeless person? Is it someone who's really acting up, like sort of, you know, deliberately being clownish, or someone, you know, I would get to that character. Yeah? And can you play ba-dum, ba-da-dum, ba-da-dum, ba-dum? I'd love to hear that. The beginning of the one, yeah.
Mm-hmm.
I would love to hear. Because otherwise, the danger would be dum da da dum ba da dum ba da dum da da da, which would be very boring. So, yum mum ba da da. Stuff that says, you know, that guy has no brain. That guy has no brain. That guy does have a brain, but he pretends he doesn't have a brain. And, you know, it's like you're, and then you, after living through all these things as a 40-year-old, you get to a point where you really, you know, do you ever question what life is for? Yeah, you do, right? So whenever you question, you know, at 16 or 20 or 21, 21 and a half, just kidding. And, you know, you still question some of those things when you're 60, 70, 80. And but maybe at 80, you say, I still don't know what to, you know, why did I do this? What is life for? What do you do? You know, you are like facing something big. You've got to imagine that and be that, right? So that's, you know, so that means, so drama, psychological drama, whether it's, you know, between you and piano, you and orchestra, and or you and conductor, you know, conductor's going this way, and you push, 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 or you pull, 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 that creates tension, right? So you're not going bum, bum, I'm just observing, I'll be together, that would sometimes not be the right thing to do, right? And then so drama, living each kaleidoscopic character, be incredibly specific, right? And so much of it is in the music. You don't have to, but whatever you find in the music, like the accent, ba, and then dot, right? That's in the music. And what you then have to do is go to the mat and fight for that character. If you give 80%, it's going to sound like 40%. You know? So to make it really speak, you've got to go 110%, and maybe people will get 90%, right? And I don't mean squeeze and play loud, but it's knowing exactly what it is specifically you need to do to get that character out. you know, so specificity. So third movement is, you know, let the harmony do the work, and you just kind of occasionally do the dotting of notes that just makes it so poignant. And in the last movement, know and ask Professor Lesser, you know, how do you do surprise? How do you do drama? What makes something dramatic? Usually something that's dramatic is not prepared. Right? So how can you not prepare for the moment that goes like this? Right? And so what is surprise? You set up something that sounds regular and then you go, aha. Right? So use everything you know. How do you tell a joke? You don't give away the punchline. So what is, you know, so find that connection between the point or the joke or the character or the drama or the surprise, and you just go for it. I think this movement, that's what you have to do. All right? And the more you know how to do that, the more you can telegraph that to other people. Then you're not sort of following somebody and saying, okay, well, you know, maybe it'll come out. You actually can telegraph the surprise. You know what people are expected to do, and you can actually prevent them from doing it or make them do it in a different way. Right? That's where, you know, this knowledge and connection is going to be very important. Okay? Congratulations.